Lavender. In the middle of the first week of Matilda's first term, Miss Honey said to the class, I have some important news for you, so listen carefully. You too, Matilda. Put that book down for a moment and pay attention. Small, eager faces looked up and listened. It's the headmistress's custom, Miss Honey went on, to take over the class for one period each week. She does this with every class in the school, and each class has a fixed day and a fixed time. Ours is always going to be 2 o'clock on Thursday afternoons, immediately after lunch. So tomorrow, at 2 o'clock, Miss Trunchbull will be taking over from me for one lesson. I shall be here as well, of course, but only as a silent witness. Is that understood? Yes, Miss Honey, they chirped. Word of warning to you all, Miss Honey said. The headmistress is very strict about everything. Make sure your clothes are clean, your faces are clean, and that your hands are clean. Speak only when spoken to. When she asks you a question, stand up at once before you answer it. Never argue with her. Never answer back. Never try to be funny. If you do, you'll make her angry. And when the headmistress gets angry, you had better watch out. You can say that again, Lavender murmured. I'm quite sure, Miss Honey said, that she'll be testing you on what you're meant to have learnt this week, which is your 2x table. So I strongly advise you to swat it up when you get home tonight. Get your mother or your father to hear you on it. What else will she be testing us on? Someone asked. Spelling, Miss Honey said. Try to remember everything you've learnt these last few days. And one more thing. A jug of water and a glass must always be on the table when the headmistress comes in. She never takes a lesson without that. Now, who will be responsible for seeing that it's there? I will, said Lavender at once. Very well, Lavender, Miss Honey said. It will be your job to go to the kitchen, get the jug and fill it up with water, and to put it on the table here with a clean, empty glass just before the lesson starts. What if the jug's not in the kitchen? Lavender asked. There are a dozen headmistress's jugs and glasses in the kitchen, Miss Honey said. They're used all over the school. I won't forget, Lavender said. I promise I won't. Already, Lavender's scheming mind was going over all of the possibilities that this water jug job had opened up for her. She longed to do something truly heroic. She admired the older girl, Hortensia, to distraction for the daring deed she performed in the school. She also admired Matilda, who'd sworn her to secrecy about the parrot job she'd brought off at home, and also the great hair oil switch which had bleached her father's hair. It was her turn now to become a heroine. If only she could come up with a brilliant plot. On the way home from school that afternoon, she began to mull over the various possibilities. And when, at last, the germ of a brilliant idea hit her, she began to expand on it and lay out her plans with the same kind of care the Duke of Wellington had done before the Battle of Waterloo. Admittedly, the enemy on this occasion wasn't Napoleon, but you would never have got anyone at Crunchham Hall to admit that the headmistress was a less formidable foe than the famous Frenchman. Great skill would have to be exercised, Lavender told herself, and great secrecy observed if she was going to come out of this exploit alive. There was a muddy pond at the bottom of Lavender's garden, and this was the home of a colony of newts. The newt, although fairly common in English ponds, isn't often seen by ordinary people because it's a shy and murky creature. It's an incredibly ugly, gruesome-looking animal, rather like a baby crocodile, but with a shorter head. It's quite harmless, but it doesn't look it. It's about 6 inches long and very slimy, with a greenish-grey skin on top and an orange-coloured belly underneath. It is, in fact, an amphibian, which can live in or out of water. That evening, Lavender went to the bottom of her garden, determined to catch a newt. They're swift-moving animals, and it's not always easy to get a hold of one. She lay on the bank for a long time, waiting patiently, until she spotted a whopper. Then, using her school hat as a net, she swooped it and caught it. She had lined her pencil box with pondweed, ready to receive the creature. But she discovered that it was not easy to get the newt out of the hat and into the pencil box. It wriggled and squirmed like quicksilver, and apart from that, the box was only just long enough to take it. When she did get it in at last, she had to be careful not to trap its tail in the lid when she slid it closed. A boy next door, called Rupert Entwistle, had told her that if you chopped off a newt's tail, the tail stayed alive and grew another newt 10 times bigger than the first one. Could be the size of an alligator. Lavender didn't quite believe that, but she wasn't prepared to risk it happening. Eventually, she managed to slide the lid off of the pencil box, right home, and the newt was hers. Then, on second thoughts, she opened the lid just the tiniest fraction so the creature could breathe.